My name is Chara Donahue, and I am a writer for iBelieve and also the host of the podcast, The Bible Never Said That. Now, I jumped in to share something with you that tends to happen to me in July. In my mothering, I tend to hit a wall when it comes to the bickering and arguing. Now, I have four kids, and I love my children with all my heart. I cherish them, I'm grateful for them. They will only be children for a short time, and I will do my best to build a foundation of love for them from which to launch them. And summer offers these unique opportunities to shape and build their character and help them to grow into people who will love God and honor God and seek Him out for all their days. I want to invest this time in the growth of their hearts and their minds and their souls, a time to inject joy and sacred moments into the stories that God is making their lives to be. I want to take advantage of the opportunity that comes during summer. But I will tell you, even in this year where they've been home way longer than they normally are, I'm still hitting the July wall. Now let me tell you what that is for me. It's the time when I kind of just have about had it with all the bickering and arguing. I have four children. They are precious, each and every one of them. But man, can they go at it with each other. And it just grates my nerves because these are the people that I love so much. And it's two people or three people or four people that I love all fighting against each other. So in case you're in a similar situation, in case you've hit a July wall in your mothering with children home during the summer, I wanted to just jump on here and share with you a couple of the verses that I use with my kids to disciple them. And basically, they're the things they hear from me all summer, over and over and over. And I have a couple questions that I tend to ask them as reminders when they're forgetting the lessons that I've tried to teach them from these verses. So the first one comes from James chapter 4, verse 1. What causes quarrels and what causes fights among you? Is it not this, that your passions are at war within you? You desire and you do not have, so you murder. You covet and you cannot obtain, so you fight and quarrel. You do not have because you do not ask. So what I use from that verse is I talk about what is it that's causing this fight between you, children? What's the deal? And I tell them it's the desires that are war within you, right? That's what James tells us. This is why they're fighting and they're quarreling and they're wanting things from one another and they're just, making me lose my mind. I will ask them the question, whose kingdom are you living for right now? Because usually when it's our desires that are in war within us or within them, it's because they are living for their kingdom. They have taken their eyes off Jesus and they said, this is my kingdom. These are my rules that I have for it. And you, sibling, have broken my rules. And so now we are at war. And I will not stand for all the little civil wars that try and break out in my house because me and my house will serve the Lord. And so I try to remind them of those things. And just that question with the teaching of this verse of whose kingdom are you living for has tended to be really helpful for them because they kind of look at it and be like, right, our desires are at war. And then sometimes they're like, our desires are at war, but this is still what I want. And then we continue to have those conversations. And the other verse that I use that's really helpful, and I have kind of like a one second reminder that I throw at them, is Ephesians 4, 29, where it says, let no corrupting talk come out of your mouths, but only such as is good for building up as it fits the occasion, that it may give grace to those who hear. Now I have, I guess, two little slogans that I kind of send at them when it's the bickering and the fighting, and I'll say, are you offering grace to your sibling? Is what you're saying right now giving grace to those who hear? Is that tone a graceful tone? So those are some of the questions I ask. Or is that building up or is that tearing down? And they kind of get that. And they've gotten it for years. They're getting older. Now, some of them, you know, they are all getting older, but some of them are young and some of them are getting into those teenage years. And these questions still help them. they have to be reminded, just as I have to be reminded, am I loving the Lord with my actions and my words? And these are the two of the verses that have really helped them over time. There are many that we can use, but these two are the ones that I've seen be the most fruitful in the lives of my children. And so in case you've been hitting your July wall, I wanted to just pop on and give you some new tools to use that come from Scripture and remind our kids we're about Jesus. We're not about ourselves. Thanks. Bye.